會議嘅議程我哋寫得好清楚嘅。咁啊，呢個
Well, it's clear on the agenda item. We have a public hearing, and then we will continue with what we have to carry on. Probably you are too occupied to take a look at the agenda.
好，咁啊，而家咧，我就繼續翻嚇我哋嘅。
Now let's carry on with our meeting of the Bills Committee on Product Eco-Responsibility Amendment Bill 2023. A few things first. The government has, in relation to the letter issued by Mr. Tony TSE on the 25th of April, made a response. It is a written response.Paper number LC CB bracket 1422/2023-01. I'll ask the administration to walk us through the paper first. Thank you, Chair. Regarding the questions raised by Mr. Tony TSE, we have provided a written response. I'll go through it quickly. The first question.Is about exemptions that we proposed on plastic straws for customers with medical needs if they, due to medical needs, ask the relevant catering premises for plastic straws, this can be exempted. And Mr. TSE asked how we can prove such medical needs. First, under the bill, weask the customer to say these medical needs themselves, as long as the catering premises think that these are reasonable needs, then such a situation can be exempted. For people with special needs, they are usually those with dysphagia or disabilities or with muscle sclerosis problems.Who require plastic straws. And Mr. TSE asked whether a medical certificate has to be presented when they ask for plastic straws. We don't think it's necessary. If you see that a customer, for instance, if it is an elderly with impaired mobility or a patient on wheelchair with muscle sclerosis, we think that in such situations, we can reasonably believe that they have the medical needs. We think that we can adopt a lenient approach to accommodate the people with special needs and also for easy practice or implementation by catering premises. Secondly, on banned products or products to be prohibited to be soldto end customers. And Mr. TSE asked how we define end customers. Well, end customers refer to those who purchase the products. And this does not include B2B or business to business use. If I purchase the relevant products for further manufacturing, then I'm not an end customer.Mr. TSE also asked if catering premises offer tableware rental services, will they breach the law? The act of renting out tableware is considered as an act of providing products under the bill.For renting out reusable tableware, of course, is not regulated under the bill, but rental services itself is an act of providing.
On the third question, the prohibition of manufacturing also degradable plastic products. Will manufacturers fall foul of the law inadvertently? Actually, one will have to add specific additives to manufacture oxo-degradable plastic products. One does not carelessly manufacture these products. Hence, there is no risk of falling foul of the law inadvertently. If there is no label, you cannot tell by the appearance of these products. So, on the prohibition of sale, what constitutes a breach if the manufacturers knowingly are aware of the oxo-degradable plastic products? Then, once sale goes on to sell it, then that will constitute the breach. Last question about balloons. Why do we not prohibit balloons? We discussed it before. Given the widespread use of balloons in day-to-day life, not least festive or celebrations, there is no mature non-plastic alternative in the market, so we have not included balloons into the bill. For the balloon sticks, what about the cups of the balloon sticks? In the definition, the cups are considered supporting the balloon, so the cup will also be seen as part of the balloon stick. So it is still within our regulation. Members, please note that the administration on the 25th of April, 422/2023, the administration has already replied to the LegCo. Now, each member, 5 minutes. Mr. Peter Shiel, thank you, Chairman. You started consultation with the trade in 2021. So, when did you last consult the committee? Which committee? Well, I mean Hong Kong Retail Management Committee. That is HKRMA. Because over half of the retailers in Hong Kong are also members of the Hong Kong Retail Management Committee, HKRMA. So, when was the last time you consulted this committee? Last time we consulted the HKRMA between July and September in 2021. Did they tell you that it took at least 2 quarters for them to order inventories? Well, I was there, but they did not put forth this piece of information. We have a close dialogue with another committee about the catering industry. We have held 18 meetings on 6 major committees, and they think that 6 months is a reasonable, acceptable time for them. Retailers, suppliers, importers, they are all different. On the 28th of April 2023, we can see the date. In general, the cycle of ordering inventories takes 2 quarters. So, they do not order goods that they are going to use tomorrow, just today. They will not do so. Even for daily products or daily household items, they also order these goods well in advance. They even order some of the inventories from overseas, so they will do so half a year ago. It's April now. When they order today, then they will receive the delivery in October, so you have to think it through for them. they will dovetail with your policy, but then you still have to make it clear for them. So you need to be clear about the cycle, not just the catering industries. Indeed, when the catering industry orders food or supplies today, then they will be delivered tomorrow. But that is a different case. You need to understand the situation facing the commercial sector. That is different. We have a close dialogue with the HKRMA. In last October or November, we had an online talk with them. We were invited to give a talk on the recent environmental protection measures, including the ordinance we are discussing right now. We mentioned a time for them to clear all inventories. We didn't specifically mention the fact that half a year was not sufficient. But if they do have difficulty, we are willing to listen to them. The general public supports this bill, so do I. But I still hope that it will not have an impact on the day-to-day operation of the logistics trade. Next, Reverend Peter Kuhn, 5 minutes. Thank you, Chairman. I'd like to follow up on the biodegradability issue. I'm just a layman. When I traveled overseas, these places are using biodegradable products, so can all of them be recycled? I'm not sure how it works. But in Hong Kong, you told me that biodegradable products cannot be used. Comparing with the situation overseas, can you explain to me? I still do not understand. Can we make biodegradable products that work in Hong Kong? Prohibition is a very passive way of handling things. If we can identify alternatives that bring convenience to citizens, then this way, it is more reasonable. We mentioned the landing scheme, but after COVID, a lot of people attach great importance to health. When they bring their own containers, as the chairman said, well, there's no problem. But when somebody has already used those pieces of equipment or container, then this will be a problem. We need to think whether biodegradable products work in Hong Kong. If so, what is the timetable? We need to think about this. I'll take the question first, and I'll see if Ms. Yong has anything else to add. We have to get it clear. The ordinance seeks to regulate disposable plastics. In this area, we do not distinguish between those that are biodegradable and those that are not biodegradable. As long as there is disposable plastic, even if it is biodegradable, it is still within our regulation. But we are not going to regulate all biodegradable products being used in Hong Kong. Apart from oxo-degradable plastic products, they are notoriously the worst products. Even if they are not single-use products, as long as they are oxo-degradable plastic products, we also prohibit this type of products. But then for reusable products, they will not be subject to our regulation. So do not think that all of these products are subject to our regulation. That is not the case. Well, I understand your point, but put it this way. For disposable plastics, simply put, any disposable items, even those made from wood, they still have implications on the environment. In principle, everyone may use some disposable items, but as long as they are degradable, then they can use it. If one is not going to use plastic fork, one can use wooden fork, one can use paper fork, etc. So, can you think of any method in relation to biodegradability? Why can overseas countries use biodegradable products, but we cannot use them in Hong Kong? Well, I heard it quite clearly. We are not targeting all biodegradable products, but for biodegradable plastic, these oxo-degradable plastic will only break down into microplastics or chemical decomposition. So we are not banning all degradable plastic across the board in Hong Kong. Yes, Chairman, you're correct. As I said, even for disposable plastic products, well, of course, these disposable products are not as good as reusable products, but for disposable products, we prefer people using disposable products that do not have plastic elements. That will be better. In a lot of advanced or developed places, they still provide degradable products. Is it true that we cannot do this? Well, I do not understand your point, Reverend Peter Kuhn. We do not ban all products that are biodegradable. We are just banning biodegradable plastic products. Probably you have to step up publicity, Ms. Yong, before you speak. Well, I'd like to better manage the time. We will overrun today. We will allow Gary Zhang to continue, and we will continue in the next meeting with the rest. For disposable plastic in Hong Kong, there are conditions to be met. But there are also districts where regions such as Taiwan, after operating for sometime, they also identify some difficulties, and now they are also regulating oxo-degradable plastic products. Because citizens do not know whether they are oxo-degradable or biodegradable. So, all of them just flow into the conventional plastic recycling system. The quality is getting worse, so they are taking a step back. We have to tread more cautiously. Next, Mr. Gary Zhang. Thank you, Chairman. We have been discussing supply, but there is also the point of display. When it comes to wording, we will discuss wording in clause-by-clause scrutiny. Do you have any concrete examples showing us what behavior we'd like to regulate? A simple example is that when I post a relevant picture on online media, is it possible that I breach any ordinance? Thank you.
Not yet.
Mr. Chang, please. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Member, for the question. Under the bill, the sale of plastic products also include the display of such products. We target online shopping platforms in this sense. Such platforms may allow various retailers to post pictures of their products for sale. If you ban the sale, they may say that they're not selling the products. And if it involves an overseas retailer, we won't be able to regulate them. If it is a platform in Hong Kong, We think that we should not allow them to display such products. So the idea is that we think if we ban the sales, we also should ban the display of the such products for sale. Yes, Mr. Zhang. Say if there is an online shopping platform, it may not only be open to people in Hong Kong. It may involve businesses around the world. So how are you going to ban the display of the relevant products if such platform is opened to customers around the world? So are you supposed to regulate them under the bill? Under this bill, we propose to regulate local suppliers and retailers. If the relevant shopping platform is a local company, then it will be regulated under the bill. If it is not a local platform, then it won't be regulated by our legislation. Well, we have completed the public hearing of this meeting, and we have conducted a discussion with the administration. For the next meeting, if members have questions about the policy, there will be time for us to have further discussion. But I believe that we'll be able to start our clause-by-clause scrutiny starting from next meeting. We hope that the administration can take into consideration of members' comments. For instance, for plastic gloves, should we only ban the free distribution but not the sale or use of them under the bill? Well, please think about that. We will have further discussion on the details of it during the clause-by-clause examination. There being no other matters, meeting adjourned. Thank you all for attending this meeting on a Saturday morning. Well, I believe that you are all encouraged by the participation of the public. Thank you.